What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today, we're heading over to the village of Woodsburg for a central air conditioning service call. A little bit of a backstory. Yesterday afternoon, I went to this job because the customer's complaint was that the air conditioning on the main zone of the home was not working, and the thermostat was reading 91 degrees, yet it was set for 60. Ladies and gentlemen, in case you don't notice, let me be the one to tell you now. The thermostat is not like the gas pedal in your car, right? If you push it down on that gas pedal, yes, your car goes faster. You lower the temperature on your thermostat, does not make the system work cooler or stronger. It still works the same way. All it is a glorified light switch. It's either on or it's off. So pushing it down to 60 degrees when it's 91 in your house is not going to help the problem. In fact, if you have a problem with your system, turn the system off, right? Turn the system off to prevent possible further damage to the equipment. All right, system was reading 91 degrees yesterday. I had them turn off, system was frozen. I said, we'll be back in the morning. Let's go see what's going on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got this American Standard Silver Series gas-fired furnace. She's a big boy. There's our evaporator coil. So the customer's complaint, no cooling. System was frozen yesterday. Nothing was coming out of the vents. He turned off the air conditioning, and hence all the water we see here and over here. The graveyard of filters. There's one, there's two, there's three, there's four. And there's five. This is the one that was in there. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, no. Hold on. We got more. One, two. Three. Four. Five. Hold on. Hold on. Six. Seven. We got seven. Seven filters here with a water panel. Anyway, I put a new filter. It's got one spare. Excellent. I put a new filter in. Let's turn the light off. Yep, I'm leaving the filters there. I'll probably take them later. I put the new filter in. I go to the thermostat. I turn on the cooling, and I hear the compressor, the outdoor condenser running. Come on, kick on. But I don't see any blower. So here we are. At least we don't have an ECM motor, because if it had one of those, yeah, we'd be in trouble. So one of the first things I like to do is make sure that our fan motor moves freely, which it does. Now, I'm gonna check next. I'm gonna check my capacitor, which is right there. It looks like it's a 15 microfarad. So let's take out this capacitor and test it. All right, it's gonna loosen up this 516 screw here. All right, and then maybe, nope, not yet. Got my little stubby here. The screw is out. Let's take a look at this capacitor. She looks pretty jacked up. 15 microfarad. Also have this fan sensor right there. So let's take out this capacitor. Thing's soaked. Okay. Get out of there, buddy. Okay. My next one. Now, let's see what this thing tests at. What do you guys think? Yay or nay? And she passes the shake test. Okay. Come on, baby. Oh, man, she's close. I think she's, 14.8. She's actually pretty good. Oh man, this sucks, but let me get a new capacitor. All right, I got my new capacitor in. Yeah, that wasn't pretty cool. got no fan. I got no fan. See? I got no fan. That sucks. All right, so we put a new capacitor in. That's not solving the problem. I don't have 110 volts leaving my cool terminal, which is right there. Right there. I don't have 110 volts leaving that terminal. Let's make sure the fan is good. I removed one line from the door switch, right, which goes to line in right there, H. See that line H? And I put my black wire from cool to the door switch, and let's turn on power, and let's push in door switch, and we have blower. All right, we have blower. So our blower motor is good. We just verified that. What is bad is that control board right there. All right, for my replacement, I'm using the White Rogers integrated furnace control. This is a universal one. It's good for PSC and ECM blower motors, right? It comes with a hot surface igniter, which is what this uses, because there's that hot surface igniter right there, right? And if you look at the list of what it replaces, hold on, sorry. It replaces 550 plus part numbers, including my Trane American Standard. This is the American Standard. I did not verify what model number this is, but let's see what we got here. We have an AUD1D. Watch, it's probably not going to be one of them. No. Yeah, we'll see what happens. Uncut, unedited, raw. All right, I got my new control in place. It's upside down, only because I didn't want to move the transformer. I only had limited slack in the wiring to connect that Molex connector. I got all my connections in place. My neutrals, all my parks, my fan control, and up there, thermostat, right there. I tried using this app, you know, it tells you to scan in with this White Rogers Connect app, but it don't work. See, there's the Connect app. I connect the device. It tells me to keep it near the device. I got the power on, of course, and I only have two hands, so it's not going to work, but it scans and then said it was an error to connect. It doesn't connect, so we're good.